So growing up, I have a pretty strong medical history from the day I was born. And so I was always, you know, in and out of hospitals, and there were doctors and neurosurgeons and engineers who had innovations that saved my life. And so when I grew up, I knew that I wanted to pay it forward in the healthcare field. And I sort of took this approach that if I can make one innovation, one device, one piece of technology, that can be used to save thousands of lives all around the world. And so that's why I study electrical engineering and biomedical engineering, to try and make the world a better place and save some lives along the way.
Definitely when I was younger, it started with a curiosity about how everything worked and how things connected. And then as I started learning more and more about how those things worked through math and science courses, I started realizing that those answers of like, oh, the way that this thing works can be applied to solve this problem. And just being able to take those connections from understanding of the fundamentals of how physics and math lets us understand the world around us, and then apply that to solve real actual problems with tangible results is, I think, the perfect definition of engineering to me, and it's what inspired me to work in it in the future.
I've always been a big fan of puzzles and problem solving, and I don't think there's a better discipline to go into that and like fulfill that passion than engineering. Over my time at Carnegie Mellon, I realized that I love mechanical systems, and just seeing how like moving parts interact is something that like always interested me as a kid, and I never realized how much I really loved it until I got to like do it for a living.